My name is Thor. I work at Unilever in an external affairs function where I represent Unilever externally on a variety of topics, including circular economy, where we try to realize the transition towards a circular economy for packaging together with partners. We are a huge user of packaging materials. In a wide range of our portfolio, we use different types of packaging, and we feel the responsibility to make sure that our packaging is also collected, sorted, and recycled into new materials. And therefore, we've set a number of commitments, including making sure that our plastic packaging is fully recyclable, reusable, or compostable, that we use less new plastic, 50% less, by both substitution to sustainable materials and an absolute reduction. We also committed that we collect more and process than we sell. And that's a difficult challenge because we cannot do that in isolation. We think we have a role to play to make sure that our packaging is circular. And that means circular by design. So we can redesign our current portfolio of packaging, that we keep the end-of-life stage also as part of our focus. But we also need to work with collection schemes, with sorters and recyclers to make sure that our packaging is actually sorted and recycled, which is often not yet the case. We work with all the value chain partners, which range from the raw material providers to the packaging companies, we call them converters, but also with retail, consumers, governments, and waste management companies that are responsible to make sure that our packaging is collected, sorted, and recycled. Since our first commitments in 2010 and later in 2017 and 19, we made a lot of improvements. We also learned a lot what works and what doesn't work. Well, some of the solutions that are there are actually on this table here. We have circular PP for Magnum tubs that are fully recyclable and made from chemically recycled content. And we also have mechanically recycled PET bottles for dressings that we implemented for Hellmann's across Europe and increasingly across the globe. These are large volumes, so we can also develop the market for recycled content. If we want to meet our target on using 50% less virgin plastic, we need to develop both the market for sustainable recycled plastic, both mechanically, physically, and chemically, and we need to invest in a market for substitution, like circular paper or glass solutions that can be circular depending on the use. In terms of progress, since 2010, we were able to ensure we have zero hazardous waste to landfill from our own operations. From the commitments in 2019, we were able to increase the amount of recycled plastic packaging, or plastic in our packaging, from almost nothing to about 22%. And we ensured that almost two-thirds of our packaging is fully recyclable, taking into account the recycling schemes in a different market. For instance, in secondary packaging, packaging materials that we use from business to business, we can reduce and harmonize a lot. If you look at laundry detergents, using more concentrated versions of the material, of the product you want to sell, compared to the previous one, we actually achieve a lot of sustainability benefits. We use less packaging. We transport less water, and it's also easier for consumers. But we do have to educate, make sure that you not overuse material when you wash your clothes, for instance. And that consumer adoption is one of the challenges, and we try to be really mindful about it, take those consumers along when we choose for concentration. We also try to make agreements with international institutions like the European Commission in Europe, or a group of producers of detergents, that we all step by step improve our concentration so the entire market goes to more concentrated versions. In nutrition, in food products, that is more challenging, of course, but you can have a concentrated soup that you dilute with water at home as well. But there are other solutions to make sure that we move to sustainable materials, such as paper-based packaging, which is still recyclable and comes from renewable sources, and recyclable plastic packaging that can actually be collected, sorted, and recycled. So we use all these options, and it depends on the product and the category what is the most sustainable option.